Hello everyone. Today we are going to learn about the present simple and the past simple. I am going to explain to you about the present simple and my partner is going to explain about the past simple. She is
Dairis Flores.
And I am Giancarlos.
Okay.
Okay guys, now let's start with present simple. It is a really simple topic. We use present simple when we are talking about habits or routines. For example, I play tennis, but it doesn't mean that I'm playing tennis in this moment. It means that it's a routine that I have. It could be because I am a deportist or because I play it weekly or monthly, or it's just a routine for me. We can use the present simple in three situations: the affirmative, the negative, and the interrogative. In the affirmative, an example could be, I study English. In this sentence, the verb is in present simple. And the structure is the pronoun, that is I, the verb, that is in present simple, that is study, and the complement, here. The next situation is the negative sentence. An example is, I don't like maths. In this sentence, we can see that we have the pronoun, then the auxiliary, that in this case is in negative. Here we have the auxiliary. Then the verb and the complement. And also we have the interrogative sentence. An example is, do you play soccer? The important thing here is to put the auxiliary at the beginning of the sentence. In this case, is do. Do you play soccer? Then we have the pronoun, the verb, in present simple, and soccer. Here we have the interrogative, that means that this is a question. However, present simple have some rules that always need to be followed, as the case of the third person. The third person is he, she, it. When we use the third person, I mean the pronoun he, she, it, we need to add S or ES at the end of the verb. For example, she cooks dinner. As we can see, the verb finishes in S because it is a third person pronoun. Another example is, she washes the dishes. In this case, the case of ES, is when the verb finishes in SH and CH and a consonant plus vowel and so on. Another example is, he likes sports. Also, he goes to the gym. It starts at 7 o'clock. The plane flies. This is something really important. We also use the present simple when we talk about facts, about general truth. Things that are always true, things that are true here in Colombia and true there in China or whatever the place you are, it is general truth. The plane flies. In the general truth, we always use present simple.
Okay guys, I talk about past simple. We use past simple to express situations that happened in some time in the past. We use past simple with verb to be in past, was where, regular and irregular verbs in past, like now, went, for irregular verbs, thought, fought, and so on. For the regular verbs, walk, work, dance, etc. In past simple, we have a rule. The first rule is verb finishes in vowel plus consonant. For example, stop, stop, chop, chop, travel, travel. In this case, we add another consonant plus ed for this word finishes in a vowel plus consonant. Okay, guys. Another rule is verb ending in consonant plus y. In this case, we change the y by the letter I. For example, cry, cried, study, studied. We notice that in this case, we add ed after the letter I. Okay? Did you understand? Okay, guys. The structure of the sentence in past simple is pronoun plus verb in past plus complement. For example, I went to the gym the last Sunday. You can see the pronoun, the verb in past plus the complement. In this case, is to the gym the last Sunday. Okay, in past simple, we can use some form: affirmative, negative, and interrogative. For example, for the affirmative form is I studied for the quiz yesterday. In this case, we use the verb in past form. This verb is a regular verb. In this case, you notice that we add ed after letter E. And the complement is with the expression yesterday. For the negative form, an example is she didn't play with us the last night. In this case, we use the auxiliary did plus the negation. The verb is in present form. In this case, play. And the expression is the last night. Don't forget the expression for each sentence. For the interrogative, is did you want to learn English? In this case, the auxiliary did is at the beginning of the sentence. And the interrogative is at the end of the sentences. Okay? In this case, the verb is in present form. Okay, guys? Did you understand?
Well, guys, that was the topic for today. That was really simple, and we hope that you like the video. So if you have some questions, you can ask in the comments and we will answer you.
Okay, guys. We hope that you share the video with other people, and if you get it, well, the talk.